Hello everyone, welcome back to Tuesday watercolour class. Today we've got a landscape painting, so follow along and enjoy. This is the drawing of the this week's watercolour painting. It's of the Kirkstone Pass in the Lake District. The outline drawing for this is available on my website at karenstudio.co.uk on the online demos page, so you can download the outline drawing there. So I've sketched it out, and as you can see, the pencil lines are much paler, so they don't show through on my finished painting. I will put up a list of all the colours and equipment that I've used for this painting, so that you can gather everything together before you start. Before I start painting, the first thing I'm going to do is reserve some of the grasses and one or two highlights on my painting. I'm going to be using Pebbio drawing gum pen. You could use masking fluid and an old pen, or an old, make sure it is an old, paintbrush or a cocktail stick to apply your grasses. Once the sky is dry, I'm now going to start on the distant mountains, painting them in a purpley mix made up of French ultramarine and light red. So just get a little bit of that on. You don't want these too dark. Do remember that your paint will dry lighter. A little bit of that. And then just add some water. And pale it as it comes down. For the next one, I'm going to do a slightly stiffer mix, so a little bit more of the ultramarine and a little bit more of the light red mixed together, make a slightly stronger mix. And into this, I'm just going to put a little bit of light red, just a little bit of, just to get a bit of variety. Thank you. Right, those distant mountains have had a little bit of time to dry, so I'm now going to start working on this next one. So again, I'm using a little bit of ultramarine blue and a little bit of the light red mixed together, make quite a dark colour. We'll start working from the top, working down. Nice rich colour. Just put on a little haphazardly, and into that I want to add some of the light red mix. And as we come down, I'm now going to introduce some yellow ochre. And if we start down and then add it up, it should mix quite nicely. Adding a bit of warmth into that distant hill. And now into that, add a bit of green. If you use sap green mixed with a little of the yellow before you start, and then just drop a little bit in. Get a nice warmth. Just punctuate that with a little bit of the dark. To add a bit more dark into the top with that mix again. Okay, I'll leave that to dry on that side. Right, so I'm going to stop there. If you want to, you can carry on, do a little more work into the walls. The danger is that you could overdo it, so do keep checking back, having a look, evaluating and deciding when you need to stop. So, as I say, I'm going to leave it there. I hope you enjoyed it. I've tried to bring some interesting colours into it and still make it a cohesive painting with a limited palette. So if you did enjoy it, do hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you again next week for another watercolour painting. Bye for now.